Okay. Show me.
Hi there, guys. Welcome back to the Dr. Shi channel. Thank you very much for tuning in. It's very much appreciated. So, this is my second video about this here aeroplane, the H-King Bixler version 1.1, version 2 somehow. It's an updated version of the 1.1. And I assume that they didn't call it the 1.2 version because the airframe itself isn't changed, for as far as I know. What has changed? I'll get to that in a few minutes. In this video, I'll tell you the details of this aeroplane, beginner airplane from Hobby King. I'll do some demonstration flying as well, of course. And I'm gonna tell you to buy this plane. Yeah. What? Dutch RC Adventures is now a sales channel. Am I being paid by Hobby King? No. Still, I am going to tell you to buy this airplane, whether you want to or not. you want to, believe me. Okay, so, and I'm pretty sure actually that there will be people in the comment section below stating that they have this plane and that they very much like it. I am completely convinced of it. Okay, so what is this? This is again the H-King. In the past is what it was probably simply the Hobby King Bixler version 1.1 and an updated version at that. Okay, there is a highway behind you if you are wondering about the sound. Yeah, okay, so what is this? This is actually two planes in one, or maybe even three planes in one, which is kind of the reason why you'd want this plane. This is first of all a beginner plane. If you haven't flown RC airplanes before, this is kind of an ideal kind of plane. A pusher style of airplane, so if you crash it nose down into the ground, your motor mount won't get damaged, your propeller, well, you get a spare propeller, but the motor won't be damaged, and even if this front part is damaged, doesn't look good anymore, it'll still fly, which is why these kinds of planes are the ideal beginner planes, because you will crash. Whether you think you are an excellent pilot before you begin, you will crash. I also sometimes crash. And that makes this kind of plane far more ideal than, say, a COP style of airplane. With the ones with a landing gear and a propeller at the front. You nose dive those once into the ground and your motor mount is gone. That's a shame. Maybe your motor axle is bent. That's a shame. And that'll happen in one of your first flights. And that'll be your first experience in RC airplane flying. So a lot of people will after that abandon that part of the hobby, which is a shame. They should have bought this kind of plane. Yeah, this kind of plane was actually my first plane as well. It was a Graupner, German brand, Rookie S, not available anymore. I'll put a picture for you on screen right now. And as you can see, it is very much like this Bixler 1.1. One major difference was that it had a T-tail, where the horizontal stabilizer was up here. I did like that more, but it's also more fragile. So, in case you are wondering what the specifications of this airplane are, I'll put them on screen for you right now. And you can obviously pause the video if you want a closer look at those. I kind of am not that much interested in specifications. No matter how good or bad the specifications are, if it flies well, I don't care about the specifications. If it doesn't fly well, I don't care about the specifications either, and neither should you. So, take them for what they are, just concentrate on my flight demonstration. Okay, so, three planes in one, what gives? Like I said, beginner plane. This is an excellent beginner plane. And it's also pretty affordable, which again makes it a nice beginner plane. I hope you agree. But take it from me, I have quite a lot of experience flying RC airplanes. This is a good beginner plane and it constitutes a good value. It's not expensive at all. I think there's also a kit, or if it's not available yet, there will probably be a kit, so without electronics. I got the bind and fly version, which means you only need to add a receiver and a flight lipo and you're off. Excellent. And the second kind of plane this is, it is a basher. Like I said, I'm quite experienced in flying RC airplanes, but even for me this is fun to fly because it's sporty. As you'll see in my flight demo, it's really sporty. From the Bixler lines of airplanes, Hobby King sells a Bixler 1, a Bixler 2 and a Bixler 3. This is the most sporty of the three. So that means that this plane can grow along with you. It's easy to fly as a beginner, but if you get more experience with RC flying, it can still be a lot of fun. So yeah, that's nice. It won't get boring after a few months of flying this airplane. Excellent. What is the third kind of airplane this is? This is an excellent platform to modify for FPV use. Maybe you want to add some motor pods to the wings, making a two motor airplane. Slice off the tips to make it even more sporty. Put another propulsion set, another motor and another ESC in it, and it'll be quite fast. So that way, yeah, you can use it for whatever. Maybe you want to add a float underneath it, so make it a seaplane. I haven't seen those for this airplane. That might be a nice addition for Hobby King, actually. Okay, so what do you get if you order this airplane? Like I said, all electronics apart from the receiver are included. So there will be servos already installed in the wings. I've covered them up with some white paper because I didn't like the black servo in the white part of the wing, but well, not important. And you have this, let me put it down, you've got this hatch at the bottom, magnetically held in place, and there you see the other two servos, the tail servos of course, and those already come installed. That's nice. You get an ESC, of course. I'm not sure if it'll be visible. Over here is a 20 amp ESC. A 20 amp. I myself would have preferred a 30 amp. Yeah. But it does fly on this 20 amp. It does get warm, hot maybe. Yeah, it gets pretty hot actually. But if you fly this plane as a beginner, it'll be just fine because you won't be flying this plane super duper fast. Okay, the ESC has an XC30 on it. Pretty common, very nice. And as you can also see, there is quite a lot of room in the canopy, in the fuselage, for your lipo. Or maybe you want to add a stabilizer. It doesn't come with a stabilizer, but you could add one. And there is more than enough room in this fuselage. However, over here in this section of the fuselage, there's also a lot of room, but it's pretty hard to get to, as you can hopefully see. right? Yeah. That's for FEV use, that might be something to keep in mind. Okay, let me actually show you how the battery slots in. I'll be flying the plane on this LiPo. There's a link to this LiPo in the description of this video. It is a Turn Synaptec 2200 3S. You want this LiPo. Hobby King suggests, I'm not even sure, other LiPos. I'd say buy this LiPo, because if you shove it into the nose completely up against the front, the plane balances out perfectly. So with these LiPos, the plane is super duper easy to set up. Just shove it into the nose. There is some Velcro included with the plane, both for your LiPo and for in the fuselage. If you shove these LiPos into the nose, the plane balances out perfectly. Right? You won't have to do any CG checking. Battery in the nose, perfect. Okay, that's why I recommend that LiPo. It'll make your life easier. Oh, and they last long. As long as you don't mistreat these LiPos. This LiPo is new. The other one I've had for 5 years. And it doesn't perform differently than a brand new one. Okay. Okay, and as you can see, the LiPo is up in the nose, but there is still quite a lot of room in the fuselage. Stabilizer, FV gear, easy. All right, assembly. When you get this airplane, you have to do two things to it to get it flight ready. You have to slot in both wings and screw them down. Two bolts are included with the airplane. Pretty simple. And the tail, the horizontal stabilizer, you glue onto the tail. Vertical stabilizer, same deal. You glue that on. And I have used FoamSafe CA. I've had one commenter tell me that that isn't the ideal glue. Works. Trust me. I have sanded down the contact surfaces a little bit. A little bit. But even that, I'm not sure if it's even needed. There is a link to the glue I used in the description of this video as well. Okay, and you have to screw on the propeller. Again, you get a spare propeller with this airplane. It is a 6x4, I think. I would have liked the plane to come with a longer propeller, but as you can hopefully see, that would hit the tail over here. Yeah, obviously you need to hook up the electronics, the servos and your ESC to your receiver. This is a 4-channel airplane, right? Motor, ailerons, elevator and rudder. So you need at least a 4-channel receiver and radio. I have an FR Sky D4R version 2 in this airplane. Works like a charm. Okay, and the last thing you need to do is hook up the linkages. So these linkages for the ailerons, I've used the outmost hole in the servo arm over here, and the outmost hole in the control rod over here. Works. And I've also used the outmost hole on the elevator control arm over here, and the outmost hole for the rudder. And with that, the plane flies perfectly. Okay, so again, if you order up the plane with this LiPo, you won't have any hassle balancing the plane out. You can opt, and that's more something for the more experienced pilots, you can use fly this plane on a far larger LiPo. Again, there's room. So if you fly a larger LiPo, you just slide it back and CG the plane approximately at 30% of the cord of the wing. If you use this servo wire as your marker for the CG, that'll work out pretty well. That'll be a safe position. But you can go a little further backwards. Okay, you know what? Let's switch to my flight demo of this airplane, so you can have a look what this plane flies like. After that, we'll get back to this this spot, and I'll give you a recap. Again, and I'll again tell you to buy this plane. I am not paid by Hobby King, but we'll do a recap. First flight of the Phoenix, the Pixlr 1.1.2. Here we go. Okay, I've been waiting all afternoon for the wind to die down, but no dice, so we're just gonna fly it as is. So, takeoff with this aeroplane is super easy. 60% throttle and throw it up approximately 10 degrees up. Or even horizontally, but I'll throw it up slightly. Here we go. And yes, it is a busy sky over here. Okay, I hope you'll be able to keep track of the aeroplane. So, this Pixlr 1.1 does not have a stabilizer, right? And it is windy. The question would be, do you actually need a stabilizer? Well, I'll try to show you. I'll point the plane into the wind. And a zero throttle. Zero throttle, I'm actually not doing anything. Well, I have to steer it into the wind a little. More than a little, actually. Okay, that was a marvelous demonstration, Dutch RC. Okay, it is very gusty, more gusty than I had expected. But still, as you can probably tell, the plane is quite stable because of them upswept wingtips. Polyhedral, if you want to know. And am I making it look easy? Yeah, probably. I'm an experienced pilot, right? But if you want a stable airplane, and that's what you want for a beginner airplane, this is definitely a stable airplane. However, can you do aerobatics with this airplane? Well, let's try, well, the first thing you'd want to try is a looping, right? So up, looping. Super easy. You just pull back on the elevator and presto. If you want to do it nicely, you'd cut the throttle or lower the throttle if the plane has reached the apex, but it's not really needed. Okay, the second thing you will probably want to do when you are starting out with the flying stuff is a roll. And yeah, the roll isn't super fast, but the plane definitely can do a roll. So the plane has ailerons. All corners I've done so far are bank and yank corners. So I put the plane on its edge like so, and I pull back on the elevator and... So again, you put the plane on one ear and you pull back on the elevator and it corners. And that's what they call a bank and yank corner. But the plane also has a rudder. So let's make a rudder turn. Here we go. A rudder turn. Now for a nice corner, you'd counteract the rudder a bit with the ailerons. Let's do that right now. And what you end up with then is a coordinated turn. Let's try that a little closer in. Rudder and a little adverse or counter aileron, and the plane stays pretty much horizontally while cornering. Okay, so the flight time with this airplane should be approximately 8 minutes. Depends a bit on how much throttle you apply, of course. I'm flying it at 50% throttle, and at 50% throttle I should definitely have a flight time of at least 8 minutes. Yeah, it is a bit of a bumpy ride. It's windy and gusty. Tough luck. Alright, so is this plane fast? Let's try 80% throttle. It's not a racer, but it gets around pretty well. There are definitely faster planes around. But is it boring? No, it's not boring. The speed is okay, I'd say. Okay, now the most difficult actually thing with this plane, believe it or not, is landing. Because it's a semi-glider, it doesn't really want to come down. Let me demonstrate that. Obviously you always want to land with the nose into the wind. So it's now flying approximately with the nose in the wind. I've cut the throttle. And yeah, it does come down, but it's very floaty, as you can tell. So, especially if you are a beginner, you will probably need a bit of room to land a plane like this. Okay, my ESC is actually stuttering, and I think that's my low voltage indicator. The LiPo was already flown on this LiPo, so that's perfectly acceptable. But okay, yeah, you really have to push it down a bit, like I'm doing right now. I hope you can actually see it. So push it down. And there. It's not hard, but again, if you are a beginner, the most difficult thing about this airplane is the takeoff, of course, and the landing. Makes sense. Okay, yeah, let's see what my closing thoughts on this airplane are. Here we go. Okay, so much for my flight demonstration of this Bixler 1.1 version 2. I hope you got a good understanding or impression of what this kind of airplane flies like. And if you are a complete, total beginner, I did make it look easy. I have to state that I am an experienced pilot, right? For me, most any airplane is easy to fly. Still, this is an excellent beginner airplane. If you want to take up airplane flying, I would suggest first starting out with a simulator, as always. Just like on quadcopters, drones. Getting some stick time in on a simulator will prevent you from crashing. Excuse me? No, it will prevent a few crashes. So it'll save you money in the end. I hope that makes sense. Let me see. What are my thoughts on this airplane? Do I have gripes? Well, some people might say, well, the tail is a bit flexible, and it is. As you could see, however, it flies just fine. If you are more experienced, you might want to add a carbon fiber tube to the tail, which is completely possible, of course, and it's not a difficult thing to do. Also, it's nice to be able to improve the RCs you have, so I don't see that as a negative thing of this airplane. Are there beginner planes like this that are stiffer? hard to say really. Maybe there's a blow molded version, so with a plastic fuselage. I'm not completely sure. Most of these types of airplanes are made out of foam, and most don't have reinforcement in the tail. And in most cases, it's not needed either. It flies just fine as it is. Okay, gripe number two. Yeah, the access, I told you this before, but the access to the room in the fuselage leaves a bit to be desired. So if you want to fit this plane out with INF, a flight controller and such, can be done. Can definitely be done, but the access to the inners of this fuselage is a bit challenging. Just so you know. Okay, the power setup. I would have liked the plane to have a 2200 kV motor. This does work out well, and maybe at a certain point the drag simply wins over the extra amount of thrust you'd have. But a 6x4 propeller and a 2200 kV propulsion setup is kind of ideal. That's what I most times use in my scratch builds, for instance. Now this setup, so the lower kV with a 6x4, I would have liked it to be able to run on 4S. So yeah, maybe you can upgrade the ESC with a 4S capable ESC stock. From what I know, this Aerostar 20 amp ESC can't be run on 4S. Correct me if I'm wrong. And yeah, okay. One more gripe: there is no air cooling, so there's no air intake at the front to cool down your battery and ESC. And obviously your battery and ESC are in the fuselage. There's no airflow over them, and the ESC definitely gets warm, especially if you fly this plane sporty. A lot of people go and mount the ESC at the outside somewhere on the airplane, which is a good idea, I think. Again, especially if you fly this plane sporty, in a sporty fashion, the ESC gets warm. There. Mine hasn't failed yet, but it definitely gets quite warm. And that's kinda it, actually. The assembly is easy, there's no guesswork, especially not if you watch my video. There's no guesswork in how to set it up, what the froze should be. I fly this plane at 100% froze without expo, and that's what you saw a minute ago. That's how I flew this plane. If you are a beginner, you might want to dial in some expo, like 35% expo. It's not really needed, as you could tell. And yeah, okay, let me get back to why you should buy this airplane. It's an affordable plane, yes, and maybe you haven't flown airplanes at all. Maybe you are a drone flyer. Expand your horizons a little, right? Try flying airplanes for a change. You will like it. Especially if you first do some simulator training. But with an airplane like this and a little bit of simulator training, you will have a lot of fun. It's a completely different kind of fun. Airplanes are... It's not... If you are already familiar with drone or quadcopter flying, it is not like you can just throw up an airplane and be able to fly it. It is different. So again, do some simulator training and you'll be good to go. But you will have fun, and it's not expensive. Right? What could be your loss? And if you are an absolute beginner at RC flying, you haven't flown anything yet, and you want to take up RC airplane flying, this is an excellent place to start. That is my take on the Bixler from Hobby King version 1.1. And again, I'm not paid by Hobby King. I think this is an excellent plane. I very much like it, even though this is a beginner plane and I am not a beginner. Very nice airplane. If you have questions, hit me up or comment down below. There is also a link to this airplane and you will be helping my channel out by using that link. Thank you very much in advance. Catch you on the next video. Bye bye.